Now we study what is electron concept. Okay, electron transfer concept. Okay, what is the definition of oxidation reduction on the basis of electron transfer concept? Okay, so electron transfer concept. Electron transfer concept. It's simple. Okay. Now, so according to electron transfer concept, what it tells actually, okay, so here the first of all definition of oxidation. It's very simple, okay, it's very simple. So it is defined as oxidation, it is defined as, you have to understand here, it is defined as a, so it is defined as a process, it is defined as a process in which electrons are removed. Okay, so oxidation is a process in which electrons are removed. That this is a simple example according to electron transfer. This is a simple definition of oxidation according to electron transfer concept. In which direction electrons removed? Okay, in which so it is defined as the process in which electrons are removed. What happens here? Electrons are removed. Okay, removed. From any atom or group of atoms. Okay, what group of atoms? It's simple. Okay, so what is, then I'll repeat here. Is it defined as a process in which electrons are removed? What it is defined as a process in which electrons are removed from any atom or group of atoms. It's simple. Okay, now you have to clearly understand what is the definition. It is defined as a process in which electrons are removed for many atom or group of atoms. Okay, it's simple. Okay, now it is defined as a process in which electrons are removed from any atom or group of atoms. Okay, now process, electrons are removed. Okay, so electrons are, let me take here example here, potassium. Let me take potassium. Okay, if I take potassium, if one electron is removed, potassium, then what happens? K plus is obtained. It's simple, yes or no, tell me. Okay, if I take calcium atom, if two electrons are removed, then what happens? Calcium 2 plus is obtained. It's simple, yes or no, tell me. It's very simple. Now if I take Pb 4 plus, okay, this is what? Plumbic. Okay, so plumbic, it forms what? Pb 2 plus. If I remove 2 electrons from Pb 4 plus, so plumbus, plumbic form plumbus. Okay, this is plumbic, plumbus. Okay, so K from K plus. Okay, so calcium from calcium 2 plus, lead plus form lead 2 plus, that is plumbus, plumbic form plumbus. Okay, so here increase of positive charge take place. Simple, yes or no, tell me. Increase of positive charge take place. I think it's simple. K gives K plus plus electron, calcium gives Ca2 plus plus 2 electron, Pb4 plus gives Pb2 plus plus 2 electron. Simple. Okay, now come to our negative charge. Okay, if I take 2i minus I2 plus 2 electron. Okay, so now I take another example here. So if I take 2i minus gives I2 plus 2 electron. Okay, now if I take MnO4 minus 2, it gives MnO4 minus plus electron. Simple. Okay, if I take FeCN6 whole 3 minus, it gives, if I remove an electron from FeCN6 3 minus, then it forms FeCN6 2 minus. You have to understand. Here the total charge is 3 minus. If I remove 1 electron from 3 minus, it will form 2 minus. It's simple. Okay, so 2i minus gives I2 plus 2 electron, MnO4 minus 2 gives MnO4 minus plus electron. Okay, so now FeCN6 3 minus gives FeCN6 2 minus plus electron. Okay, these are the examples of what here you see clearly. See here, atoms, these are the atom or ion or group of atom. Okay, group of your atom or is atom or it is ions. Okay, so you can take any whatever you want. Okay, but it is atom or it may be ions. Okay, so here it is defined as a process in which electrons are removed for many atom or group of atoms. Simple, yes or no? This is the whole example. Here, what happens? Here, as you clearly see, here negative charge decreases. Here, minus 2 present, here minus 1, minus 3, minus 2. Here, what happens? In all the examples here, negative charge decreases. Decreases. Okay, you have to understand it clearly. Here negative charge decrease कर रहा है यहाँ पे. यहाँ पे क्या हो रहा है बच्चे? यहाँ पे सबको समझना है. यहाँ पे electron remover electrons हो रहा है. Okay, so remover electron means what? Oxidation. These six examples are the examples of what? Oxidation reaction. I think it's simply clear. Okay, I think सबको समझ में आ रहा है. यहाँ पे oxidation क्या है? सबको समझ में आ गया. ठीक है, तो नेक्स्ट हम कंटिन्यू करते हैं यहाँ पे रिडक्शन रिएक्शन. यस और नो? टेल मी अगेन. आई क्लियरली टेल द डेफिनेशन. इट इज डिफाइंड एज अ प्रोसेस इन व्हिच इलेक्ट्रॉन्स आर रिमूव्ड फॉर मेनी एटम ऑफ व्हाट. व्हाई इट इज कॉल्ड इलेक्ट्रॉन ट्रांसफर कॉन्सेप्ट? बिकॉज इलेक्ट्रॉन इज ट्रांसफर हियर. ओके, इलेक्ट्रॉन व्हाट हैपेंस हियर? इलेक्ट्रॉन इज ट्रांसफर. ओके, सो दैट व्हाई इट इज कॉल्ड इलेक्ट्रॉन ट्रांसफर कॉन्सेप्ट. ओके, आई थिंक सिंपली क्लियर. व्हाट इज ऑक्सीडेशन रिएक्शन? देन कम टू आवर व्हाट? रिडक्शन रिएक्शन. ओके, so come to our part, reduction reaction. You have to understand what is reduction reaction. Okay, okay, so what is reduction reaction? Then according to electron transfer concept, reduction, okay. Okay, reduction reaction. So electron transfer, according to electron transfer concept, what is reduction reaction? So it is a process. Okay, it is a process in which electrons are added. Okay, it is a process in which electrons are added by atoms or group of atoms. Okay, group of atoms. Okay, it is a process in which electrons are added by atom or what? Or group of atoms. It's simple definition. So it is according to electron transfer. So this is the example. Okay, so this is the definition. Okay, so it is a process in which electrons are added by atoms or group of atoms. Simple. Okay, now come to our example. Okay, so if I add what? Electrons. Okay, addition of electrons means what? Reduction. Okay, if I take Pb4+. If I take Pb4+, two electrons are added, then what happens? Pb2+ is of plumbus. So it is an example of what? It is an example of reduction reaction. Okay, so if I take calcium 2+, two electrons, then it's from calcium. Okay, it is an example of what? Reduction reaction. Okay, so here calcium is 2+, else calcium is 0. So whatever, reduction reaction. एक प्लस एडिशन ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन मीन्स रिडक्शन ना. यस और नो? टेल मी. बहुत ही सिंपल है. सो यहाँ पे समझना है कि ये एग्जांपल यहाँ पे क्या है बच्चों. यहाँ पे ये सब एग्जांपल यहाँ पे रिडक्शन का है. ठीक है, SN4+. तो टू इलेक्ट्रॉन यहाँ पे ऐड करते हैं. स्टैनिक है, ये स्टैनस हो जाएगा. SN2+ हो जाएगा. ये स्टैनिक है, ये स्टैनस है. सबको समझ में आ रहा है यहाँ पे? बहुत ही सिंपल है. तो नेक्स्ट हो गया हमारा यहाँ पे. तो यहाँ पे आप क्या लेते हैं अभी यहाँ पे? सो AS5 अगर लेंगे यहाँ पे, ठीक है, AS5. ओके, AS5+ आर्सेनोस. ओके, आर्सेनिक. तो यहाँ पे क्या हो रहा है? यहाँ पे AS3+ हो रहा है, प्लस टू इलेक्ट्रॉन. अगर टू इलेक्ट्रॉन रिमूव कर दिया, ठीक है, सॉरी, यहाँ पे अगर एडिशन ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन करते हैं ना, टू इलेक्ट्रॉन ऐड करते हैं, सो एस क्या हो जाएगा? यहाँ पे 3+ हो जाएगा. सबको समझ में आ रहा है? एडिशन ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन मींस व्हाट? रिडक्शन रिएक्शन. सिंपल, इट्स वेरी सिंपल. यू हैव टू अंडरस्टैंड क्लियरली व्हाट आई टेल यू. ओके, व्हाट आई राइट हियर, यू हैव टू अंडरस्टैंड क्लियरली. ओके, सो AS5+ इज कन्वर्टेड टू AS3+ बाय एडिंग टू इलेक्ट्रॉन्स टुवर्ड्स AS5+. ओके, so it's clear here, 2 electrons added to Pb4+, 2 from Pb2+, here 2 electrons added to calcium 2+, from calcium 0, and here 2 electrons added to calcium stannous, that is stannic, SN4+, 2 from SN2+. Okay, here 2 electrons added to AS5+, 2 from AS3+. Simple. Okay, here the definition, it is a process in which electrons are added by atoms or group of atoms. Okay, so this is the whole definition of reduction. According to our electron transfer concept. Okay. So this is the four examples our. Okay. Let me another example here. MnO4. MnO4 minus plus electron. It gives what? MnO4 2 minus. It's simple. Okay. Now FeCN6. FeCN6. What? FeCN6. If I add 4 minus. Sorry. If I take 3 minus. Okay. So this is called as ferricyanide. Okay. So if it is plus electron gives, what happens here? It gives FeCN6, what? 4 minus, okay. So these are the examples, these are the 6 examples of what? Reduction reaction. So these are the whole 6 examples of what? Reduction reaction. Okay, it's simple. I think you clearly understand what is reduction reaction. Okay. So next, we'll come to our part. Oxidation number or oxidation state. Okay, I think you clearly understand here. Okay, so according to, again I'll revise here, according to classical concept, what is, according to classical concept, oxidation is a process in which oxygen is added or any other electronegative element or removal of hydrogen or any other electropositive element. Okay, this is the whole example definition of oxidation according to classical concept. Reduction kya ho gaya according to classical concept? Reduction is the process in which addition of hydrogen take place or any other electropositive element, removal of oxygen take place or any other electronegative element. This is according to our classical concept. Okay, then next according to our electron transfer concept. Okay, next according to our what? Electron transfer concept. Oxidation is defined as a process in which electrons are removed. Okay, oxidation is defined as a process electrons are removed from any atom or group of atoms. It's simple, yes or no, tell me. Next is our reduction. Reduction is a process in which electrons are added to atoms or group of atoms in a chemical reaction. You can tell that, okay. So these are the whole examples, are the difference, okay, the difference of between classical concept and is our what, modern concept or our what? Our electron transfer concept. Okay, now so next is our oxidation number. Okay, next is our what? Oxidation number. Next is our oxidation number or oxidation state. So simply, if I have to write the definition of oxidation, first you understand what is clearly what is oxidation number or oxidation state. Okay, so if I write here Ca2+, here 2+ is the oxidation number of calcium. Okay, if I write MnO4 minus, okay, minus, okay, minus 1 is the oxidation number of MnO4 minus. Okay, not O, not manganese. Okay, you have to understand clearly. Okay, if I take here O2 minus, then minus 1 is the example of oxidation number of O2. Okay, you have to understand. Okay, so the whole charge, okay, the whole charge present in a single atom or what? The single atom or group of atom in a compound, okay, is called as oxidation number. You have to clearly understand. Okay, so simply the charge, okay, the charge present. The what? The again I repeat here, oxidation number. Okay, oxidation number is defined as oxidation number is defined as the charge present द चार्ज प्रेजेंट, ऑक्सीजन नंबर इज डिफाइंड एज द चार्ज प्रेजेंट ऑन एन एटम और ग्रुप ऑफ एटम, सॉरी ओनली ऑन एन एटम इन ए मॉलिक्यूल, ऑन ए सिंगल एटम, ओके, ऑन ए सिंगल एटम इन ए मॉलिक्यूल और एनी कंपाउंड। कंपाउंड विच में भी आयोनिक और नॉन आयोनिक, विच में भी आयोनिक हो सकता है और नॉन आयोनिक भी हो सकता है, ठीक है। सो सिंपल, ऑक्सीजन नंबर इज डिफाइंड एज चार्ज प्रेजेंट ऑन एन सिंगल एटम इन ए मॉलिक्यूल और एनी अदर कंपाउंड विच में भी आयोनिक और नॉन आयोनिक, ओके। सो आई थिंक यू क्लियरली अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट इज ऑक्सीजन नंबर हियर, ओके। Now, if I write here, Ca2 plus, then oxygen number is 2 plus. Okay, here is the oxygen number of calcium. Oxygen number of calcium is 2 plus. Okay, if I write N3 minus, then oxygen number of nitrogen is 3 minus. Okay, if I write here 2 minus, then oxygen number of oxygen is 2 minus. Clearly, I think it's simple. If I write here H plus, then oxygen number, okay, what happens? Oxygen number of hydrogen is plus 1. Okay, you have to understand it clearly what I write here. Okay, now if I write here F minus, then oxygen number of fluorine is minus 1. If I write Cl minus, then oxygen number of chlorine is minus 1. If I write I minus, then oxygen number of iodine is minus 1. Okay, if I write H2 minus, then oxygen number of sulfur is minus 2. Okay, if I write FeCN6 whole 3 minus, then oxygen number of the whole, so this is the oxygen, this is not the oxygen number, this is the total charge present on the combination of ions. Okay, this is the compound, FeCN6 compound, okay, so 3 minus, okay. So here oxygen, we have to find out here oxygen number Cn minus is minus 1, okay, so you have to find out, okay. So if you have to find, so you have to take here x, so okay, we will study later, okay, how to find out the oxygen number, x plus 6 into minus 1 equal to minus 3, okay. So here x, so here that is equal to plus 3, okay, so here oxygen number is plus 3, okay. So simply this is the oxygen number of iron is plus 3, oxygen of Cn is minus 1, okay, so it's simple. So, how to find out oxygen number? Okay, we'll clearly study later. Okay. So, this is the whole definition of oxidation number, oxidation state. Okay, so I'll clearly tell you here. Oxidation number is defined as of charge or present on single atom in a molecule or any other compound that is non-ionic or what? Ionic. Okay, you have to understand clearly what I tell you here. Okay. So Ca2 plus here form, that is in Ca2 plus oxygen number of calcium is 2, in oxygen number of nitrogen is here minus 3. Okay, these are the whole examples of what? Our oxygen number and oxygen state. I think you clearly understand. Okay. Now some rules. You don't have to remember all these rules. Okay, you just have to use these rules. You don't have to remember that. Okay, if you use these rules, then you don't have to remember these rules. Okay, so I have to write here some rules. Okay, 7 or 8 rules to find out the oxygen number. How to find out the other oxygen number? Okay. So I have to write here the rules. So you have clearly seen here the rules. What are the rules? Okay. So as you see, I clearly write here the rules for assigning oxidation numbers. Okay. So first rule you have to know clearly. One by one, I will clearly understand you. So, I will clearly tell you what are the meaning of these rules. Okay. First one is our oxidation number of all atoms in the elementary state or allotropic state is 0. What do you mean by that? Okay. It means that in nitrogen, you clearly see in nitrogen here, okay, in nitrogen, chlorine, Cl2, HCl, P4, SH, these are the examples of singular mole atom. Okay, in all these kind of atoms, okay, oxygen state is zero. Okay, if I have to say here question, what is the oxygen number of nitrogen, N2? Okay, so it is zero. Okay, but it is zero. Okay, so it is zero. So here, if I take nitrogen, so first of all, if I have to find out the oxygen number, I have to take X upon that. Okay, you have to take X, then X equal to, so here how many X? 2X, so 2 into X equal to 0. So X equal to 0 by 2, that is equal to 0. So that means in all the elemental state or allotropic state 0, okay, oxygen number of all the atom of a same or different element, okay. तो यहाँ पे जो जब यहाँ पे सब है यहाँ पे N2 Cl2 H2 है हीलियम फास्फोरस सल्फर ओके दिस आर द एग्जांपल्स ऑफ आवर डिफरेंट एलिमेंट्स ओके सो इन दिस स्टेट दैट सिंगल स्टेट और दैट इज आवर इन मेनली रेयर अर्थ दैट इज आवर रेयर एलिमेंट्स दैट इज आवर व्हाट हीलियम व्हाट इज हीलियम नियॉन आर्गन क्रिप्टन ज़ेनॉन रेडॉन ओके दिस आर द ग्रुप 0 और ग्रुप 18 एलिमेंट्स ओके दे all these the single elements okay singular elements okay in these cases these are all have zero oxidation state okay so you have to say that these are the valency of these ions okay valency means the valency means what helium neon argon they don't form any bonds okay clearly see but xenon krypton is form compound so you can say that but approximately all shows no valency, that means zero valency. That's why the charge is zero. So, okay. The first one is our oxygen number of all atoms in the elemental state or allotropic state is zero. In N2, Cl2, H2, helium, phosphorus, sulfur, etc. Oxygen number is zero. Okay. Next compound, next is our oxygen number of monoatomic ion is same as only. Okay. If I have to take here calcium, okay, calcium 2 plus or carbon 4 plus. Okay. If this is monoatomic, okay. See, it said that here, oxygen number of monoatomic ion is same as ornate. Okay, here 2 plus is present, so here oxygen number of carbon is 2. Here 4 plus is present, so oxygen number of carbon is 4. But this here it is said that. Okay, next power, oxygen number of hydrogen is plus 1 when combined with non-metals and is minus 1 combined with metal. Okay, what do you mean by that? When oxygen number of hydrogen plus 1, okay, but it means that if I have to take here HCl, okay, here Cl minus 1, oxygen number here plus 1, okay. If I have to take here HF, here it is minus 1, it is plus 1. If I take here NaH, sodium hydride, okay, then it is plus 1, then it is minus 1. Here, when hydrogen is attached to the metal, sodium is a metal, okay, it has oxygen number minus 1. When hydrogen is attached to any non-metal, that is chlorine, fluorine, nitrogen, oxygen, all gases are non-metal, okay. So, mainly 7 or 9 non-metals are present in the periodic table, okay. So, non-metal gases, okay. 7 or 9 gases are present in the periodic table. So, Cl minus HF, these are the minus here, plus 1, then why? Because hydrogen is a non-metal, chlorine is a non-metal, but in case of metal, when metal, that is sodium or potassium, if I take here potassium, okay, KH, okay, plus 1 here, minus 1. So, here, in hydrogen, here hydride, this is called sodium hydride, potassium hydride, this is hydrogen chloride, okay. So here potassium contains plus 1 charge and hydrogen contains minus 1 charge. Here sodium contains plus 1 charge, hydrogen contains minus 1 charge. Simple, yes or no, tell me. I think it's very much simple. Okay, if hydrogen is attached to a non-metal, that is chlorine, fluorine, okay, all the gases are non-metals, okay. So then it has plus 1, that is charge, as oxidation number, but when it attached to the what? Attached to the our metal, then it forms our minus charge. Okay. In metal, oxygen number is positive. In non-metal, oxygen number is what? Negative. It's simple. If I have to take metal, if I have to take here sodium, okay, NaCl, okay? NaCl is plus 1, which is minus 1, simple. Okay, these are the valence. You have to remember charge. Now you have to understand how to find the charge. You have to remember the charge. You have to remember the valency. It's simple, okay? The sodium has plus 1, okay? All the alkaline metal, okay? Alkaline metals are the examples of our what? Here's the alkaline metal here. Hydrogen, alkaline metal, okay? Lithium, okay? Hydrogen, lithium, sodium, potassium, rubidium, hydrogen, lithium, sodium, potassium, rubidium, cesium, francium. These are all the examples of alkaline metal. Okay. What? This is called as alkaline metal. All have the valency that is our plus one valency, that is charge is plus one. Okay. If it is attached to a what? If it is attached to a except hydrogen, all have valency plus one. If because all are the metal except hydrogen is the non-metal, so hydrogen contain minus one plus one, but all have plus one. Okay. So it's simple. Plus one maybe more. Okay. So next is the alkaline earth metal. If I have to take alkaline earth metal, you have to understand. If I have to take here alkaline earth metal, that is barium. Okay, barium, magnesium, okay, calcium, potassium, calcium, barium, magnesium, calcium, strontium here. So barium, magnesium, calcium, strontium. Barium, radium, okay, it is beryllium, this is radium, okay, Ra means radium. So beryllium, magnesium, calcium, strontium, barium, radium. These are the examples of alkaline earth metal. Okay, you have to understand here, these are the alkaline metals, and then these are alkaline earth metals, okay. So, this is our third rule, that is oxygen number, fourth rule in metal, oxygen number positive, non-metal is negative. In neutral compound, the sum of oxygen number of all the atoms is zero. Simple, yes or no, tell me. In neutral compound, the sum of oxygen number of all the atoms is zero. Yes or no? It's simple. Okay. In neutral compound, the sum of oxygen number of all atoms is zero. Okay. That means, it said here, if I take a carbon dioxide, all here carbon dioxide is neutral, NaCl is a neutral compound. Okay. So if I have to find here carbon oxygen minus 2, if I have to find out the oxygen number of carbon. Okay, so carbon x plus 2 into minus 2 is equal to 0. So equal to yahan pe 0 likhte hain. So kyun? Kyunki yahan pe total charge 0 hota hai. Sabko samajh mein aa raha hai? If I have to write here, you have to understand here. If I have to write here FeCN6 3 minus. So if your question is find out the oxygen number of iron, then it is minus 1. So x plus minus 3. Okay, x plus 6 into minus 1 equal to minus 3. So why equal to minus 3? Because total charge is minus 3. But here total charge is 0. Because as it is a neutral, it is anionic. Okay, it is an anionic complex. It is a neutral compound. So here x is what? X is plus 3. So oxygen number of iron is plus 3. So you have to understand here it is minus because it is that is equal to minus 3 because there is a whole charge of the compound. Here the whole charge of the compound is 0. Okay. So this is simple. Okay. Now come to our what? Now come to our third last part. In complex and the sum of the oxygen number of all atoms in the ion is equal to charge on the ion. Yes or no, tell me. In complex and the sum of the oxygen number of मैंने भी बोला हुआ है यहाँ पे efficiency total charge जैसे यहाँ पे क्या 3 minus है तो यहाँ पे सब कुछ समझ में आ रहा है. In complex and the sum of the oxygen number of all the atoms in the ion is equal to charge on the ions. Okay, so Fe here one iron is present, 6N minus is present. Total charge of these atoms or ions is equal to minus 3. Yes or no? It's simple. So I think clearly understand the 6 rules for assigning oxygen numbers. Now we'll come to our problem part. How to determine the oxygen number of a atom in a molecule or a compound that is maybe ionic or maybe non-ionic. Okay. Or maybe complex. It can be complex. Okay. So now we come to our problem part. How to determine the oxidation number. Okay, how to determine the oxidation number of any compound or complex. Okay, now question is just simple. We have to start with simple questions. Find out the oxidation number of all the atoms present below. Okay, here question is N2, second question is O2, third question is F2, fourth question is O3, fifth question is S8, sixth question is iron, 7th question is our phosphorus. So I think there's no problem here at all. You can clearly say that all compounds have same oxidation number, because the rule number 1 said that all neutral compound containing same atom or different atom, okay, so containing or allotropic form of atoms are having zero oxidation number, okay, this is rule number 1. So all have zero oxidation number, okay, as your single atom or single allotropic form of atoms are present. So when single or allotropic form of atom is present, that they have zero oxidation number. So all have zero oxidation number. Okay, if I have to find out, they have to find out, okay, if I have to take here N2, so here I have to take your X, okay, so here N2 is 2, so 2 into X equal to 0. Why equal to 0? Because in nitrogen, okay, you have to understand how to find out, okay, I have to find out. So clearly said here, if I have to understand here N2, okay, N2, you have first of all you have to take X here, okay, first of all you have to take X. Now X equal to X, so how many X, so two number of nitrogen present, so 2 into X equal to 0. Why equal to 0? Because in total nitrogen, if I have to see here, in total nitrogen there is no charge is present, it is as it is neutral, so there is no charge is present, that's why it is its charge is 0. So what happens here? So X equal to 0 by 2, that is 0. So charge of nitrogen is 0. Yes or no, tell me. I think it's simple, very much simple. You all clearly understand. Yes or no, tell me. The value of X is what? 0. Yes or no, simple. Yes or no, it's very simple. Okay, so X equal to 0 by 2, that is equal to 0. Okay, so like that all other atoms are like that O2, okay, you have to take your O2X, okay, so you have to take here X, so 2 into X equal to 0, so what happens here, X equal to 0 by 2, that is 0, so all the neutral, sorry, all the singular atom or allotropic form of same atom is having oxidation number is 0, okay, now come to our next some problematic part of our, okay, so next is our, so complicated questions here, okay. Now question number here, calculate the oxidation number of all the atoms, okay, here. So here I will write your question, what is the oxidation number of the following underlined atom present in the following compound? Okay, so you have to understand, what is the oxidation number of all the following underlined atom present in the following compound? Yes or no, tell me. I think it's simple. Okay, now first of all, I will write as the following, in the following compound, the following compounds are, first one is our ClO3-, second one is our BrF3, yes or no, BrF3, third one is our CH4, fourth one is our C6H12O6, okay. So simply we will clearly here understand how to find out the oxidation number of the following complex, sorry, not complex, the following compounds, okay. So first of all, we will take our what, Cl, okay, so here these are the underlined, here Cl underlined, here bromine underlined, carbon is underlined, here carbon is underlined, okay, these are the underlined atom, we have to find out their what? We have to find out their oxidation number. So those atoms which we have to find out the oxidation number, first of all, let me write the X upon them. Okay, here I write X. Why? Because you have to find out the oxidation number of the atom. Okay, here upon bromine, I have to write X, on carbon, I have to write X, on carbon, here I write X. Okay, so now clearly see, okay, here I write here ClO3. Simple, okay, you have, here I write X. You all know that oxygen always have minus 2 valency. Okay, so charge oxygen minus 2, it's simple. Now come to our part, X plus. So charge is minus 2. So how many? 1 oxygen content minus 2. So 3 oxygen contents. It's simple. 2 into 3. Okay. I think there is a charge present. Yes or no, tell me. ClO3 में बच्चों यहाँ पे समझना है. बच्चों ClO3 में यहाँ पे कितना चार्ज है? माइनस चार्ज है. सबको समझना है. Means minus 1 है. So equal to minus 1. सबको समझ में आ गया. बहुत ही सिंपल है. So क्या हो गया यहाँ पे? X minus 6 equal to minus 1. सबको समझ में आ गया. X equal to 6 minus 1 is equal to plus 5. Yes or no, tell me. I think it's very much simple. Okay. So X equal to what happened? X equal to plus 5. Next is a BrF3 minus. Okay. If I take here BrF3. Now I write here 1 is Br, then is our F3. Okay. So Br upon X here Br. We all know that all the halogens have oxidation number minus 1. It's simple. And fluorine is fixed. Fluorine has minus 1 always. Okay. So fluorine has minus 1 oxidation state. So X plus 3 into minus 1. Now clearly see, in BrF3 there is no charge present. That means it is neutral, so equal to 0. It's simple. Okay, now what happens here? Minus 3 equal to 0. So what happened? X equal to plus 3. So ho gaya yahan pe. So oxidation number of bromine equal to plus 3. Here oxidation number of chlorine equal to what? Plus 5. It's simple. Yes or no, tell me. Okay, now come to our CH4. Okay, C. Then here H4. Okay, here upon C we have to write X upon hydrogen. As these are the both what? Both non-metals. Okay, sorry, carbon is a metal. So we all know that if a metal is attached to, then it is minus 1. Yes or no, tell me. I think it's simple. Okay, it's simple. So you have to write here minus 1. According to the rule, if a metal is connected to the carbon, that is a hydrogen, then it has oxidation of minus 1. So X plus 4 into minus 1 equal to 0. So kya ho gaya yahan pe? X minus 4 equal to 0. So yahan pe kya ho gaya? X equal to plus 4. Sabko samajh mein aa gaya? Simple hai yahan pe. So yahan pe kya ho gaya? Oxidation number of carbon is equal to, so bahut hi simple hai, is equal to plus 4. So it's very simple. Next come to our 6 is H2O6. Okay, this is glucose. Formula of glucose is 6H12O6. How to find out the oxidation number of carbon in glucose? So it's simple. So here oxidation number is here C6. Now I write here H12O6. I have to write here X. Okay, here plus 1, oxygen is minus 2. So 6 into X plus 12 into plus 1 plus 6 into minus 2. As it is a neutral molecule, so equals to which you have 0 ho gaya. So simple hai, pe 6x plus 12 minus 12 is equal to 0. So 12 you have to write. So you have 6x equal to 0. So x equal to 0 by 6, that is equal to 0. Simple. So here the oxidation number of carbon in glucose, in what? In glucose is equal to 0. Simple. Okay, oxygen number of carbon is plus 4, oxygen number of bromine is plus 3, oxygen number of chlorine is plus 5. So this is the whole idea how to determine the oxygen number of any single atom in a complex compound or any compound. Okay, so I think that's all for today. Thank you.